Please make some noise for Megan Peacock.
Okay, so I hate posing for photos because, like, this is my face. This is all I have to work with, okay? So at, like, a momentary glance, it's okay. But, I mean, if I have to pose for a photo, like, for, like, a school photo, I, like, make these pathetic attempts to, like, compensate. So because I think my eyes are too small in photos, I'll like, make them really wide. But then I also think my mouth's kind of wonky, so I'll, like, even it out a bit. But then also my face feels a bit chubby, so I want to make it a bit thinner, right? So, and then I had this problem because the longer it takes, the more my body starts to compress, and I get physically smaller, so... This was my school photo. I mean, it's become like a big problem for me now because none of my friends want me in any of their photos. Like, they haven't explicitly told me this, but guess who's the designated photographer? It goes down a little something like this. Oh my God, we're having such a great day. Like, let's take a picture and remember it forever. Okay, so none of my friends sound like that because, well, for a start, they're all English, so... but just stick with me. Megan, can you take the photo? Because, like, you're so good at it. We'll totally get you in the next photo. I guarantee that the photo they upload is the photo that I'm not in. And they'll caption it something sickening like, beautiful times with beautiful people. Apparently a category that I don't qualify for. What's even worse is, like, if I actually am in the photo and they upload it, I'm cropped out. I cease to exist. There's no room for this potato with eyes. So I have self-esteem issues. And no, it's not because when I brush my teeth I get toothpaste everywhere other than the assigned area. No, I do that, but it's not because of that. And it's not that my friends say that my complexion looks like moldy milk. No, they've said that, but it's not that. And it's not because my optician once told me I was going to get a lazy eye and then laughed in my face. No, he said that, but no, it's not that. It's that, again and again, on multiple occasions, in increasingly bitter terms, my mother has told me that I failed to distinguish myself on the occasion of my birth. Yeah, when my mum went into labour and started pushing, I started panicking, so I pooped. And I was so stressed that I started to get hungry, and what was there to eat? My poop. Yeah, I did that. So apparently it would seem that before I even left my mother's womb, I was full of shit. The funny thing is, my mum said she only told me this because my brother kept telling me I was adopted. God, I wish I was adopted. The thing I do love is sleep. I absolutely love sleep. I am sleep's number one fan. Like, 90% of the time I'm awake, I'm dreaming about being asleep. But this becomes an issue as, like, a visitor to New York, because, I mean, this is a city that never sleeps. But I do. I sleep. So could you be quiet? But not right now, because I'm done and I'd like some applause. Thank you.